plunge into the political process, the process of electing a president here in the United States. You're mayor of Burlington, Vermont. From your perspective in that job, what kind of a person would you like to see as president of the United States?
Well, I would like to see somebody who has the guts to begin to stand up to the people who own this country, to recognize that in our nation today we have an extreme disparity between the rich and the poor, that elections are bought and sold and controlled by people who have huge sums of money. So my first concern is to have a president who has the courage to look reality in the face and say that we need some radical changes in this country so that every American can have the opportunity to have a decent standard of living and live a decent life.
Through. Who are you worried about? Iraq? Panama? Who are you worried about? I'll tell you who I'm worried about. I'm worried about the fact that our workers are seeing a decline in their standard of living. They want to see our industry be rebuilt. That's what they want to see. No more B-2 bombers. No more Star Wars. Let's make the quality products we need. Let's invest in American industry. No, I won't yield. The American people want to see our kids educated. They want a Head Start program. They want their kids to be able to go to college. They want to wipe out the fact that 5 million children in this country go to bed hungry. They want child care for their kids. They want decent education.
Homosexuals in the military.
You said something about homos in the military. Was the gentleman referring to the many thousands and thousands of gay people who have put their lives on the line in countless wars defending this country? Was that the group of people that the gentleman was referring to?
I'm talking about the military people in the military do not support.
That's not
the
what we were
bill.
Talking about. You use the word homos in the military. You have insulted thousands of men and women who have put their lives on the line.
Way back when I was a little bit younger, I was involved in civil rights demonstrations, and I was there with Martin Luther King Jr., Dr. King, in the March on Washington.
That freedom is never given to you. If it's given to you, it's not real freedom. You gotta struggle for it, you gotta fight for it, you gotta take it.
And what we understand, and what every one of us has always understood, is that real change never occurs from the top on down, always from the bottom on up.
Together, my friends, we have begun a political revolution to transform America. And that revolution, our revolution, continues.